lot of battles, but there's more in store. If you're gonna be a soldier, know what you're fighting for. We the battle axis, Yah's weapons of war. We won a lot of battles, but there's more in store. If you're gonna be a soldier, know what you're fighting for. We the battle axis, Yah's weapons of war. We won a lot of battles, but there's more in store. If you're gonna be a soldier, know what you're fighting for. We the battle axis, Yah's weapons of war.
Thank you.
You know why they weren't friends? He said, beware the wolf and sheep.
Okay.
We weren't friends because it's a commandment. The reason you don't, because you don't obey God.
Why would God say that though?
What?
If they weren't going to be wearing fringes in 2018.
Let me get that, then I'm going to come back and see. I'll show y'all how much of a fool that's in here. See, all of this other fool going to agree with
that. Oh, what do you say about that word though?
The Bible calls you a fool. I ain't calling you that. When you going against this Bible, that the Bible says you are the fool. Well, we're gonna read that too. We're gonna read what God called you. And not what I say. We're gonna see what God called you a fool.
Bless you, my bro. Bless you, my bro.
19:21.
Bless you, my bro.
The book of Luke, chapter 19, verse 21.
Since his brother think we're supposed to be weak and not rude, let me show you what Jesus Christ himself was. Let's see if he was hard or not. Let's see if he was soft spoken. Let's see what he was dealing with the people all nice.
No, he was. I am the Christ.
For I fear thee, because thou art an austere man.
Hey, what?
An austere man.
Jesus was a what man?
An austere man.
Jesus was a strict austere. He stood up bold and strong. Jesus went into the goddamn temple and knocked everything in the temple over. What the people went up there. You think he was a soft punk? No. Jesus, your house side was just like we was, and that's how we're going to stand every time we come out here.
That's
you
right.
You like it, then you got 2 feet. Take them. Put one in front of the other and walk yourself down the block. And if you don't, if you want to bring out your own little stuff, what's that say you? There's a corner right there. There's a corner over there. There's a corner on the next block. Pick one of them, and you can run your mouth all day long. Free. Deuteronomy 28:54.
The book of Deuteronomy, chapter 28:54. So that the man that is tender among you.
But this brother want us to be, he want us to be tender. He want us to be soft. He want, nah, that's what you insinuated the whole damn time. You
and
everything else. Yeah, you did. See, now you make your word things, but you know, we don't play semantics. Disrespectful language. Like I said, I didn't disrespect you. I'm telling you what God said to the Lord.
Putting words in my mouth.
Tell God that he's disrespectful. Now, that's what you said, bro. He told you exactly what you said. You said you didn't say it. And this brother is very delicate. That's why he can't get with no brothers out there. That's why he ran out on the streets running with those fringes on.
How you know?
And ran out here
and do
absolutely nothing.
How you know?
Because you ain't with nobody.
How you know?
I said you ain't got with your people.
I'm with my people right here.
That's not who God told us to gather to. Gather with.
But how do you know that though?
You ain't got
assumptions.
Like I said,
disrespectful.
You know what you gonna do?
Then we talked. We just talked to this brother last week. Wait before that. That's what
how
he said.
Know?
Did he not say that?
How do you know?
Bring it
out. How do you know?
You out of your mouth.
How do you know? How do you know?
I shall be evil toward his brothers. I shall be what? Shall be evil toward his brothers. Yeah, he don't like the Israelite. He just like to imitate the Israelite.
You ain't
Israelite.
No teacher. You ain't no teacher. You a bastard, bro.
And poor the white of his bosom.
A teacher's supposed to have patience.
Go ahead.
You're not even living the way you're preaching, bro.
Evil toward
live
his
what you preach.
Start from the beginning.
Live what you preach.
Gotta come y'all. He say he will hit you, they will hit you.
Come here. Like preach. This is what the Bible says. When they get tender,
you ain't practicing.
See how tender he is now?
Nothing tender over here.
See, that's tenderfoot.
You ain't practicing what you preaching, though.
If I was combing his hair,
disrespectful, bro.
Yeah, he's tender here. That nigga would be crying. If I pull out a car right now and whip it through one of them plants, that nigga was going to cry. Because he's a tender liberal.
Right now, these niggas getting exposed.
Oh, that's a man.
You that is tender among you.
Exposed. You don't have no compassion.
He's very what?
No passion. No, you're not passionate, bro.
A very
there's no pureness in your heart, bro.
We had this brother been out here. He's talking out here
me, bro.
Now he wants to come to class,
bro.
Brother.
No, you be a clown, bro. You a clown, bro.
But you want to get out here.
You a clown, bro.
You a clown, bro.
You a clown.
gonna scoff now. I like it a little bit.
His eye shall be evil toward his brother.
That his eye evil toward him. You see what I'm saying? Because he's tender. You're showing it.
I'm a
bastard.
He got on war guard.
Because I'm a warrior.
No, right. God is a warrior. God said, the business is his. Why you got on war guard?
Because
you trying to fight. Have faith in the Lord. You scared. You think somebody going to fight you?
I know you ain't going to fight me. I don't want to fight you.
You scared.
I would not want to hurt you,
man.
Because I'm at war right now.
You at war?
Yes.
Spiritual war. You don't need war.
What are you talking about?
Answer to chapter 15 verse 3. The Lord is a man of war.
The Lord is a man of war.
The Lord is a man of war.
And he's a king over his army.
Why do you have those spikes on?
Because I want them. I like
you here to fight, bro.
Man, I've been out here for 3 years, and I ain't fought nobody. And I want these out here every day.
He is here to fight.
That's what you call Baron Foster. That's what you call Baron Foster.
Why you got
to be in
Calamity? Ezekiel 37:10. So I prophesied as he commanded me.
He said, so we prophesied as he commanded us to do.
He is
to his brother, man, because, boy, when you call that thing sin, see, when you call that stuff out,
bro,
he get upset.
Bro,
he gets mad at him. Oh, oh, he did. That's a lying on people. That's a bearing false witness on people.
Nah, brother.
So I prophesied as he commanded me, and the breath came unto them, and they lived, and stood up upon their feet, an exceeding great army.
An exceeding what?
An exceeding great army.
Nah, but we're supposed to be the little soft-spoken little man of like the white man talking. Hey, be quiet. Calm down. Calm down. Chill out, you brothers. Chill out. But we ain't like that. I'm a loud man like your Howard shot. They had a voice of rushing water, of a loud, deep voice.
He did.
Yeah, that's what he did. Give me Proverbs 1 and 22.
I got you.
Y'all think we scared of y'all? I ain't scared of none of y'all. They're like the burning back saying, I ain't scared of you, mother.
You guys done right. You don't stay out here like
stay out here like what?
You don't stay out here.
That's because you ain't a band of commanders, and you wouldn't have to stay out here. I don't want to be homeless. I don't want to be on the street. Because I am blessed by the Most High. And I, boy, these niggas, they proud to have that thing. That's what he is, huh? That look, he was a wolf and she's calling.
That's him.
That's the wolf and she's calling. He
right
around here with him, huh? I'm out here waiting for a thing to come and stop.
They not even here.
The book of Proverbs, chapter 1, verse 22. How long, ye simple one?
How long, ye simple one? When you read that in the Bible, when you look that word up, that Bible, that means, how long, you stupid one? How long, you stupid one? Ring.
How long, ye simple one? Will ye love simplicity?
How long you gonna love stupidity? How long y'all gonna listen to this idiot?
How long would you do that?
Speaking something, nothing in the Bible.
Show me the Bible.
And this brother right here. Read.
Show me the Bible.
What did God say?
What did God say about calling people idiots? What did God say? What did God say about calling people idiots? What did God say? What did God say? What did God say?
So that's why we come out the Bible. Because anybody can tell you anything. Now, I want to see what God tells me.
God bless you, brother.
And you scorners delight in their scorning. And fools hate knowledge.
And what's that brother getting on the bus who's scoffing?
And fools hate knowledge.
What's that brother that sit around here acting like he knows something but don't?
And fools hate knowledge.
Why that brother don't got no knowledge? Because the brother up there, he's talking about he ain't an Israelite. Won't pick up a Bible.
I ain't got no feeling.
He want to run his goddamn mouth.
I ain't got no feeling. 30 years old.
And we bringing everything out of the Bible. No, he's debating the Bible. Jesus was an austere man. Paul was an austere man. Jeremiah was an austere man. Ezekiel was an austere man. And Nehemiah was one of the hardest men in the Bible. You think he's playing with
the Bible?
No. Nehemiah grabbed him by your hair and snapped your neck.
You
and that's what they want us to be.
If you in the front.
That's the thing about it. People don't want to be told they were done wrong. You didn't like it when your parents did it, and your dad sure don't like it when God did it wrong.
He said,
"Who's
the book of 2 Peter, chapter 2, verse 16. But was rebuked for his iniquity, the dumb ass speaking with man's voice.
Rebuked for his iniquity, the dumb asses speaking. And the brother talking about we ain't supposed to call nobody a fool. The Bible call you a dumb ass. A dumb ass.
Bring it out, huh?
I didn't say it. The Bible said you a dumb ass.
You know he was
going to say it. I mean, y'all think I made that up. Read that again.
Work it out.
Oh, we can't call him that. Well, I'm going to tell you, let's see what God called you then. Don't take my word for it. Don't think I'm cussing you out. The Bible said this.
The book of 2 Peter, chapter 2, verse 16. But was rebuked for his iniquity.
He was rebuked for his iniquity. And let's see what else he said when he was rebuking him.
The dumb ass.
The what?
The dumb ass.
That jerk that is running his mouth.
The dumb ass.
The one that's sitting here that don't know nothing, arguing with the scriptures.
The dumb ass.
You dumb ass. A lot of dumb asses out here. Because you won't hear the word of the Lord God. But y'all go and listen to any damn body that's talking. Negro is proud to be home. Nobody proud. Oh man, y'all ain't out here like we do. We get down out here under the bridge, in the homeless shelter, pissing in the corner, pissing on each other. And you proud of that?
Proud of that, huh?
And you praise the white man because he give you another dollar to come back on the streets tomorrow. And y'all proud of that. It's a sick nation, a sick people. Y'all need to wake up. We dealt with him before. That's what Issachar's supposed to be. Why is he trying to do these law, statutes, and commandments, man?
Remote.
He got that bull crap in his ear, man. That's what be wrong with these people, man. They listen to garbage.
Sleep on garbage.
Don't do nothing of the, that the Bible speaks of. Mr. Man, sir. With the brown derby on and a leather coat. I see you looking, but now you want to know me when I address you. That's what's wrong with our older men. He think he a distinguished gentleman. But he's just an old fool. He's an old ass. Just like the Bible said. Now you guys got your attention now. When I try to speak to you, see, that's what you got to do to our people. You got to cuss them out to get their attention.
Bring that out.
But when you try to be respectful to them, they ignore you. These are fools and idiots. Old fools and idiots. Old ignorant Negroes. The same one that was out there talking, I'm going to march. March for what? Do the law, statutes, and commandments that God told you.
That's right. Out.
I love Martin Luther King. You love a man who can't do nothing for you. You love a system that is broken, that is against you. And you think you hot because you got on a hot-ass leather jacket. That's, boy, I'm telling you, our people ain't nothing but some wicked Negroes. Wake up!
That's right!
Wake the hell up!
Verse 17, as for us, our eyes as yet failed for our vain help.
He said, now for us, our eyes fell for our vain help. You don't listen to the elders of the Bible. So now you listen to everything that they're telling you on in this earth. Everything the so-called your enemy is telling you. You listen to that. You black women, you listen to everything the white man got to tell you. But your brother that's in the truth, oh, I ain't gonna listen to him. That nigga talking about that nigga reading the Bible. He telling me what God saying. I like when I listen to the dummies. It sound good coming from the dummies, because the dummies make me think I look good. And the Negroes, the dummies think, the dumb women, they make me think I'm fine. All I gotta do is give them about $100 every night. Read.
As for Shalat, in our watching, we have watched for a nation that could not save us.
But all this time, y'all all depending on America to save you. Now you got Donald Trump. And now you Mexicans all. Y'all depending on America. That Negro built the wall to tell y'all to get y'all ass up out of this country. And this is y'all land.
That's right.
And then they up here telling, they want you out of their country. And then guess what? If everybody look down on this ground, guess what? Every place you step on is stolen property.
That's right.
So how you gonna build a fist around something that ain't even yours? That's double stealing. How you gonna steal from me and then take what you stole from me to your house and lock it up in your safe? That's a master thief, a master robber. But this is what y'all got, y'all hoping that Donald Trump do something. Y'all hoping that any one of these days they gonna go in the United Nations, they gonna say, hey, get them niggas their money. We owe them reparations. And you think as soon as they, boy, what's so bad about it if they gave y'all the goddamn money right tomorrow, the majority of you be dead next week. Because the Negroes on so many damn pills and drugs, you ain't gonna do nothing but take the money and go buy more of them. Then the ones that drink all goddamn day, you ain't gonna do nothing but go buy some more liquor. You'll be dead next week. Hell, if I was the government, I'd give you $1 million. And guess what? It's only gonna be about 14 goddamn Negroes left tomorrow. Cause all them little dumps, they ain't gonna do nothing but buy nothing but drugs. I'm on lean, what are them, four balls. I'm on every damn thing. I'm on one. That's what they on. This is our people, man. Our people are sick nation of people.
Appreciate that.
Go back to the 1 and 22, man. Go first, give me a 1 and 7 first. First, give me 1 and 7. Proverbs 1 and 7. Because our people, man, it's a sad thing, man. It's a sad goddamn thing when our people out here, man. Look at us. Like I said, that brother right there was a goddamn cheerleader for the Be Homeless. You proud. You proud to have nothing, huh? Yeah, you proud to have nothing. I can see. That's a sad saying. It's not funny. It's sad, man. It's sad that our people are in that state of mind that they accept being on the bottom. When the Most High God told you, you was above and better than everybody on the planet.
That's right.
Give me Deuteronomy 7 and 6.
Yeah.
Because y'all don't even understand. You don't even realize how what you are. But you accept mediocrity. Because you've been taught to be on the bottom. You've been taught to like this state. You've been taught to be out on the cotton field. You was taught to like picking cotton. You was taught to like eating the pork butts of the worst parts of the goddamn animal. You was taught to love pigs. You was taught not to eat right. Shalom, what's your nationality according to the Bible?
I ain't got no problem.
You know who you are? The way you got your hair going, but do you know who you are as a person?
Man, they call me Masaf.
Masaf, come here, Masaf. I'm Maccabee.
Maccabee, we friends. We come from above, but yeah. They don't want to go. But I'm behold yourself.
Let me ask you something.
Oh, wait, Bob.
Behold
yourself.
Listen. No, you behold yourself.
You think heaven is above?
Heaven is right here, but it ain't our heaven.
That's right. That's what
heaven means above. That means
never,
the government.
You would never find that in this concerned book right here.
Yeah,
it's not going to tell you.
This Bible tells me everything.
That Bible's going.
It tells me the spirit that you're working in right now is wicked.
Thank you, brother. God bless you.
I feel you. You don't listen. You don't want to listen. See, that's our problem with our people.
28, for real.
Yeah, I already know. Y'all, you just see how I knew. This dude just looked at me with what you got doing on terror mind. I seen that. I lied to call terror on him. So that's what I'm telling you about terror. That's what come out of that. Yeah. Ready? Look at him, man. I that bug the hell out. Nigga, he got a nice George Jefferson going. He looked just like Paul and him. That's good. That's good. But his mind gone. Read.
This is Deuteronomy chapter 28, verse 28. The Lord shall smite thee with madness.
That brother right there was just smite with madness. Man, I'm trying to tell you, man. This is our people. These are the ones, some of y'all look at it thinking, they all right, and they'll run their mouth to you, and you'll listen to them. But when we bring the Bible out, you don't want to listen to the Bible. But you sit on a train, listen to the dude that just broke out of the goddamn mental hospital. He just took the white garment off. And sitting on the train, that you'll listen to.
Won a lot of battles, but there's more in store. If you're gonna be a soldier, know what you're fighting for. We the battle axis, God's weapons of war. We won a lot of battles, but there's more in store. If you're gonna be a soldier, know what you're fighting for. We the battle axis, God's weapons of war.